What do you want to hear here? And especially from the perspective of somebody who knows and hears from cities across the state here, as well as municipalities, about some of the tough challenges that lay ahead. Words like infrastructure. Give me an idea what you hope to hear at a convention that are more substance rather than just political sloganeering.
Yeah. Well, I mean, and certainly the slogans are important at these events because you want people to have appropriate aspirations about where the leadership is trying to take us. But certainly an affirmation of the federal government to be a partner with states and with localities in helping to rebuild our economy. That's the big issue for everybody. It's jobs, it's a quality of life. It's very clear, we see it in New York, that we have so many municipalities, many of our cities particularly, that are really on the edge when it comes to fiscal stress. We've been reporting on that. And you look at, if nothing changes right now, the automatic federal budget cuts that are supposed to be triggered starting in January, and that's actually the beginning of the last quarter of our state's fiscal year. So we could stand to lose billions of dollars in the short term for New York State, for our localities, which can only make a bad situation worse. So more about what the goal is in terms of avoiding those automatic cutbacks and getting the federal government back to being a partner in terms of investment. It's going to mean monetary support. You know, everybody talks about infrastructure. The reality is, you know, we are billions of dollars short in terms of the money available. Tappan Zee Bridge alone, right? Our favorite topic, you know, downstate, really all across the state, everybody knows how important Tappan Zee Bridge is. We can't rebuild that on our own. But you multiply that by all the other smaller bridges and roadways and highways and sewer systems and water systems. There needs to be a recommitment of the federal government to help localities. That'll relieve the burden on local property taxpayers, but also these kinds of investments will put people back to work. And I think the message really needs to be, it's not only about reelecting President Obama. We really do need a change in the Congress. One of the big frustrations that I have, and I think that many have, is that the president has had some specific plans, and I really think it's part of a political calculation just to deny him any success. The House of Representatives...
Isn't the fault of that, though, also rest on his shoulders from a messaging standpoint? Maybe with guys like me, it doesn't fit into a soundbite. Yep. But you ask the average person to define how healthcare changed them, or how even how the stimulus maybe even saved their job, unknowingly or otherwise. Yeah. Is that part of the problem that they got to figure out the next few
days? You could always do better messaging. I think that's fair. But when you look at how everything has played out, starting with healthcare, the president reached across the aisle, looked for partnership. The hand wasn't extended. And certainly when there was a change in leadership of the House of Representatives, that dynamic just got worse. I really think there was a combination of a political calculation not to give him a victory. And the reality is you had some more extreme voices on the Republican side who were elected as part of the Tea Party Revolution that have not made it conducive for the kind of civil discussion about how you compromise. I mean, that's how you get something done, especially when you have a divided political dynamic. So I'm hoping this election resolves some of that, obviously in favor of the Democrats, I would hope.
Well, help put a face in this, because you go across New York State here, and not just assessing the health or some of the challenges facing the economy, but you get the macro and micro of the middle-class voter. And everybody agrees, this is so much about identity politics, the middle-class voter here has been the one on the short end of the stick for so long, especially the last 4 years. What do they want to hear that maybe they haven't heard yet?
Well, I first and foremost, I want to hear that people understand that they're scared, that they're not secure with their future, they're not secure for their children's future. They certainly would like to hear plans. I think everybody understands. You can't wave a magic wand and have everything go back to the good old days. But I certainly think what they didn't hear out of the Republican convention was very much on the positive side in terms of initiatives. It was more just criticizing
Obama. The president should give specifics.
I think some more specifics, but I think the president also needs to, and Bill Clinton, I think, will do this as well, and Joe Biden, remind everybody just how bad it was at the depths of the recession, which was largely inherited by the president. He came in and things went from bad to worse. And the fact that the steps that were taken, be it the stimulus and now that we're seeing some of the health care reform be enacted, that has made a positive difference. Has it made unemployment go away? Well, obviously not. And this recovery has been too slow. So I think the challenge is to remind everybody as to how much worse it could have been, and that's a tough message to get across, but it's a real message, and also convey there's an understanding of the pain of the middle class, that the middle class is what's going to get this country through in the future, more fairness in terms of taxation, and a reminder of the specifics of what the president's put out there that's been held up by the Congress. And I think that's going to be a winning formula, coupled with the fact that the president is still the kind of person I think inspires people with his leadership. I don't think the other side has produced candidates that will give that sense of inspiration.
Last thing, I'm asked a lot from folks outside of New York, how is it that the governor of New York has such a high approval rating, especially given maybe it's New York, but it's still facing a lot of same challenges as other places do. You have an answer?
Well, I think he's been doing a good job as governor. Not afraid to tackle tough issues. We have a split legislature in New York, as you know, the past two sessions, been able to work out agreements. So you haven't had some of the gridlock in New York that you've seen in other places that have a split legislature. And look, we went through some tough times. We had some difficulties at the executive level. Everybody remembers that. It wasn't so long ago. And Governor Cuomo came in with a mandate to get back to business, and that's what he's doing. I think people appreciate that and respect that.